I'd like to begin by once again playing this clip for you guys to spotlight the promise that was made surrounding this game.
So our promise to the community is that we won't have random loot boxes or pay-to-win scenarios.
No random loot boxes and no pay-to-win scenarios. No gameplay affecting microtransactions. Now, for a time, that did hold true. You can see the prices here for the cosmetics sold in the game, which are woefully overpriced, especially in a game that already charges a $60 premium to buy it. It's not a free-to-play experience. But suspicions that gameplay affecting microtransactions were coming were fueled by this blog post on March of 2021 when it was announced that how experience works would be overhauled by essentially diminishing its pacing because, according to what the developers claimed here, there were pacing issues such as skill points currently being rewarded too fast, and that may be confusing and overwhelming to newer players. I don't know who ever complained to Square Enix and to Crystal Dynamics that this game felt too overwhelming in terms of its skills output and how fast people leveled. This just felt like an excuse that they were giving themselves to lower the rate at which you earn experience to essentially sell back the solution, which is exactly what ended up happening. Now, the developers try to clarify once again in this Reddit post, but you can see from 32% approval rate that people did not buy into the bullshit that it had to do with leveling up and gaining experience being too overwhelming, or this notion that the current pace of leveling diminishes your ability to explore each skill purchase. Nobody ever complained about that. Lo and behold, fast forward a couple months later, and we're looking at a situation where the marketplace got some new items, and right down here you can see what are XP boosters and currency boosters, which expedite the pace at which you can achieve certain goals within the game. And many people noted the timing of this happening right after Marvel's Avengers gained a decent amount of traction when it launched on Game Pass. So this was Square Enix and Crystal Dynamics' way of exploiting those players, this infusion of players, and trying to nickel and dime the game this way. And all this happened during a time when the game was already facing backlash for other issues, like the Tachyon Surge perk getting nerfed to a point where it basically killed endgame builds. And at the time, there was an Xbox live stream where they were showing the game where a bug caused the stream to end, which obviously is very bad for optics, given this is a game that is notorious for its technical issues. And now, with the breaking of a blatant promise that there be no pay-to-win elements in this game, no gameplay affecting microtransactions, even the most loyal fans were saying stuff like, I no longer support this game doesn't have the luxury to do this when there's so much to be fixed, so much. And then other people essentially echoing everyone else's suspicions on why selling XP boosters feels greasy. Number one, nerf XP because players are getting overwhelmed, quote unquote, and we all know this is BS. Number two, start offering double XP months and quadruple XP weekends when you told your players they were getting overwhelmed. So that proves it was bullshit, and they did indeed do that. Various events where they actually gave you tons more XP, but hey, I thought that was actually a flaw that would cause people to get overwhelmed. Yeah, turns out they don't care about that. And finally, number three, they did this after the launch of Game Pass, which launched alongside a 4x XP weekend. All signs point to everything being planned and being intentional and them knowing exactly what they were doing with trying to nickel and dime a surge of new players and intentionally breaking promises they know they made. Now, just yesterday on November 2nd, 2021, Marvel's Avengers finally caved to pressure from backlash with the following statement where they apologize for the indiscretion of charging money for gameplay affecting items after promising they'd never do that. And they announced right here that they have decided that by the end of the day, they'll be removing Heroes Catalysts and Fragment Extractors for purchase, or removing the XP boosters and currency boosters and gameplay affecting microtransactions. Here's their full statement. We apologize for not responding sooner to your concerns about the addition of paid consumables in the marketplace. So something that a lot of people are asking is, what took you so long to respond? People spotted the gameplay affecting microtransactions in the marketplace back in October 7th, 2021, and it wasn't until November 2nd, 2021 that Marvel's Avengers finally addressed this. That's what, like 26 days after all the backlash began to pour in, I guess they were fine with, you know, spending a month trying to rake in as much cash as they could before finally backing out on this, knowing how awful for optics this all is. We introduced them as an option for an evolving player base and did not see them as pay to win since they don't offer power directly. Since when is offering power directly the definition of pay to win? Pay to win is anything that helps you win through payment. And it doesn't matter how major the advantage is. It doesn't matter if there's still some skill involved or whatever. If it gives you an edge in any way, shape, or form, if it gives you a gameplay advantage, then it is pay to win. And this is what companies try to do often. They try to change the definition of something that now is stigmatized, like how EA tried to change loot boxes into surprise mechanics that are fun and ethical. And now they're trying to say, oh, well, pay to win is only explicitly if there's a button that literally makes you win. EA tried to make a similar excuse with FIFA, saying, well, you can get all the best players, but you still have to know how to play the game. You still need to be skilled at the game, know how to take advantage of the players that you paid for. But what if two players are evenly matched and one player has tons of money and the other one doesn't? And so this player has the better team. Obviously, the guy with the most money who opened all those loot boxes and gambled for all of the most coveted players with the highest skills and highest stats will have an edge, and that will help him win, therefore pay to win. Now, Marvel's Avengers obviously is more of a co-op game, but there are still goals within this game that you can achieve, and XP boosters and currency boosters expedite the rate at which you get to those goals. It helps you win in this specific scenario. It's pay to win. Stop trying to pretend like you can skirt around the pay to win definition. You know exactly what you meant when you said no pay to win elements in Marvel's Avengers in that E3 press conference. You were saying no gameplay affecting microtransactions. And in fact, further specification was provided by head of Crystal Dynamics Scott Amos when he straight up said back in June of 2019, in terms of how we monetize, we'll have cosmetics. No gameplay paywalls. So the promise here wasn't just no pay to win, and even if that was the promise, the fact still remains that what Marvel's Avengers tried to pull with the latest microtransactions was very much pay to win. He straight up said no gameplay paywalls. So even with Square Enix and Crystal Dynamics trying to skirt the way around the definition of pay to win, the justification still doesn't work because they've also said no gameplay affecting elements that you can pay for to expedite gameplay elements. The only microtransactions we have will be cosmetic. Stop bullshitting us and stop pretending like you didn't know you were breaking that promise that you made on multiple occasions, worded in all kinds of different ways. Own up to the fact that you got greedy and be straight with us if you intend for this apology to be taken seriously. And then comes the important bit. After considering your feedback, we have decided that by the end of today, we will remove Heroes Catalyst and Fragment Extractors for purchase. You should also be removing that based on your own feedback that you gave us when you made the promises that you did. They will continue to be earnable rewards, and those already owned are still usable. We hope that this can be the first step in rebuilding your confidence in us as a team. No. All confidence, unfortunately, is lost at this point. Not only is this apology full of bullshit because of this bit right here where they did not see them as pay to win, we did not know this would be perceived as us breaking our promise and them trying to skirt their way around this issue. Not only is that bullshit, but this isn't the first in a series of awful decisions surrounding this game. And the way you earn trust and goodwill is by consistently making good choices, not by constantly backing out of bad decisions. You backing out of something that you knew was bad but decided to go for it anyway until the fire got too hot and then backing out, that's not gonna win you brownie points. That's just scummy. Especially when the state of the game is where it is at now, especially when the game still has so many issues that don't seem to be the priority compared to the microtransaction stuff. They're gonna have to do a lot more to even begin to take the first step in rebuilding the community's confidence in them after everything that's happened and after they continue to make bad decisions. The statement finally concludes with, "It continues to be our goal to make the very best game possible. Could have fooled me. Thank you for being part of the Marvel's Avengers community." Now, that's not to say that the reversal of including gameplay affecting microtransactions in the marketplace isn't a good thing, but this is certainly not something we should be patting the devs and the publisher on the back four, given this is something that should have never happened in the first place. This is an attempt that should have never been made, and they surely knew this. If we're looking at this from a goodwill perspective, and this is baseline, they're like right down here, and then they put themselves even lower with the decision to include gameplay affecting microtransactions, and the reverse only takes them back to the negative in which they're in right now. They have such a long way to go before reaching baseline goodwill and then starting to build positive goodwill. And one little reversal of an awful decision isn't going to change much of anything. And it's certainly not going to help rekindle a dying player base that's getting more and more fed up with the shenanigans surrounding this title. But that, ladies and gentlemen, is the latest on what's going on with Marvel's Avengers. They backed away from a bad decision after they caved to backlash, and the game's still in a really, really bad place. Let me know in the comments below what your thoughts and opinions are on these latest developments. And to be further updated on all things gaming news, reviews, and discussions, stay tuned right here on Young Yeah. I'll see you guys next time. Young out.